Hi guys, I'm just shading this design on a half crown, and half the reason is for practice, and half the reason I think it'll make an interesting looking coin. So what I'm going to show you is the different effects that different gravers create. I always prefer a wide graver. This is a Steve Lindsay 123 degree, and it makes a really nice light to fix. Can you see on this section? I used a 96 degree graver, which is a thinner one. It's good if you're going to put paint in an engraving. The thin one's quite good because it makes a deep, thin line, so it really holds paint well. But I never really liked it. You can actually see it there. It doesn't make very good black. See there? It looks kind of grey. You see this, nice and black it goes. There's no ink or anything in that. It's just the way the light. It's quite a polished, not polished, but it's a smooth graver. And it's not very deep though. It's not as deep as this, so you think, oh, it's not as substantial. But I much prefer it. But when I do this kind of thing, I change my technique slightly. Although I think it's going to be a finished design, I vary my technique to make it more interesting and also to experiment. So when I look back at this, I'll kind of see what I like the look of. So, and then you add that to your style. You do one that you like the most. So basically what I did, I sectioned it off coming from the eye, and what I'm doing is leaving a little, so I sectioned it off, so like say sun rays or whatever, and let me show you on this. I'm leaving a little gap in between each section, so that'll look really white, it'll look like a white line. With this kind of thing, you've got to do the whole thing to get the effect. So, and then just going radiating from that. So a gap left this side and a gap left that side, and then shade everything. And I'm trying not to overshade it, because that's what I tend to do. I put too many lines in. Or, you know, if you put less lines in, it would create one look, and if you put a lot of lines in, it would create another look. So, but with soft metal, you have to be careful putting too many lines, because it gets all choppy. With steel, you probably could do quite a lot of like fine lines. You wouldn't do them as deep, but less likely to get choppy. So, what are we doing? I'm just making, oh, you can see it there, so I'm just shading in, so when that's done, it'll kind of look like it's, give the illusion that it's darker towards his eye. Alright, I don't even feel like using the 96, I was going to demonstrate the 96, let me do a little bit with the 96 and... Right, so this is taken out at 123 degree. I'm putting the Steve Lindsay. No, never mind. We'll forget that for now. I should have put it back where I normally put it, but I had it handy and couldn't find it.
Right, so this is going to be a 1960 degree graver. I don't want to do too much, so this is. And see, it's going a lot deeper, but it's not going very wide, so there's not much interest, or not. There is thin and thick, but it's so fine that it's hard to see. So to my mind, it looks like you're not very, very good engraver. You can't vary the line. No, I won't say that. You haven't practiced that much. And with this thing, you need to get in a rhythm. Even I do it. I mean, I've just got it now. I've only been engraving this a little while this morning. But your first 20 cuts aren't as good as the ones after that, so no matter how long you've been engraving, you need to kind of warm up. So I'll turn the power down a little bit. All I have to do is just wind the cylinder in and out on this one. And I like a lot of power, but you do have a lot less control with the homemade machine. But you've got to be able to control the power, so I'm okay with it. But if you turn it down slightly, it's a bit more relaxing, and I don't need to go that deep with these. So. Oh, that's not too bad. The technique I'm doing on some of these is, so you can see I've shaded it towards the centre, but then I go inside each line again in a bit, so then that'll create a different. This is what I mean about experimenting with different lines that I've cut already. But when you're doing, like I say, about turning the power down with this, like I'm gonna drive over his ear now, you need quite a bit of power. So let me show you power to keep the line a bit. You'll never keep it that consistent because the surface is bumpy, but if you haven't got the power, then it rides over and the line will look different, and you might not want that. But I can drive, let me drive over it now as it would if I didn't have the power. So it would ride over the surface rather than me cutting through the surface, so that line would be quite weak. See that line, a bit more pronounced. Get a see what seals go. So that's the only downside with the cheap compressor. The seals don't last. But if you keep them well oiled, maybe silicone oil, I think that would make them last quite a long time. So. And I don't think I'll put any paint or anything in this. I'll just leave it as it is. So it's a nice effect. Let me show you. Because with this effect, it looks black at one angle, and then you turn it another angle, and then it looks kind of white, but sparkly. So. I'll finish this video. Right, so let me show you what I mean. Right, see how nice and black that looks? So that this is the really black section is the 123 degree. And you tilt it. See, it's got that optical illusion, three-dimensional effect. But if I put paint in, it wouldn't have that, it wouldn't give that, maybe it would a bit, but, and close up it looks kind of disgusting. not disgusting, it looks dirty close up, but you see so there is a little bit of dirt going in there, but they're perfectly cut lines. The surface is perfect, the mirror polish surface. Right guys, some random ass for you there, but it's all practice, so doesn't matter, really matter what you do, as long as you're steering the graver. Cheers guys, hope that helps. Bye.